Everybody, this is Nick with Tom Schaefer's RV. Today we're going to be going over the Avenger Prime Time 22BH. If you're a first-time RV buyer or just getting started in camping, this little unit will do the job for you, especially if you're looking for bunkhouse. This is going to fulfill bunkhouse. It's a no slider, so it's going to save a lot of weight for you too if you don't have a big enough truck for the unit you want just yet for just starting out camping, but the amenities of what you need to camp. So let's go check this out. As you can see here in the front, you are going to get one propane tank, and then you're still going to get your manual jack. You can upgrade that to an automatic jack later on if you want to, but start out for the price cost that it's at, it's going to be a manual jack for you. Over here, there's no solar charge or anything on the top of this. You do get a little Furion outlet here if you want a solar charge for 10 amps. They do give you a choice to plug something in here. And you do get a pass-through storage on this side, so that goes fully to the other side there too. If you work your way around to the other side, and of course this is a traditional sticker tin unit, it's a wood frame unit. So we'll look at the gross vehicle on this, is $74.95. So the unloaded, you're going to be right around 45, honestly. Your dry weight is actually 38, sorry. Dry weight's 3,800 pounds, right there it is, see? Stickers will help you. And then this other storage door, it's to the other side. So you got nice big storage on that underneath. And you could access that underneath the bedroom inside too. Continuing on the non-camp side, as you can see, this is a non-slide unit. So a lot of that weight is gonna be helping that you don't have to drag a little on an extra 800 or 1,000 pounds for a slide. So you can stay a non-slide and then you don't have to upgrade a truck, you know, if you're right on the cusp line of pulling something along this lines of the weight. You do have your hot water heater over here. You get your city water fill, you get your fresh water fill, you get a 30 amp unit, and then your heater is right there for suburban. Like I said, you are on a dual axle unit, which is really nice. All your outlets are in one place, so your black and gray are all in the back here. You do get manual stabilizer jacks as well. Cable hooking in the back for you. Rolling around to the back, this does have a bumper, so if you want to put a bike rack on it, you can, but you do get your spare. You do get a backup camera prepped as well if you want to. You can get that prepped, the Furion system. Here it's about $500 to add on the backup camera and to add on the little 4.5-inch screen too. You get an outdoor shower. Outdoor shower outside is really nice. If you go to the beach and you have sandy feet, you're able to wash that off pretty quick. So continuing on the camp side of this 22BH, you get a doggy leash. So if you got a doggy outside, take him, and you can actually have a leash little holder on here for the outside, so you don't have to bring an extra thing along for you too. And then other storage underneath. So this is gonna go straight through to the other side inside the unit. So you get a nice big storage back here. And then your campsite awning, you see they do have LED lights on the top of it. You do get an outlet over here. Put outside TV out here if you want to or not. You still get outlet and plugs, or in case you want your other lights on your awning, you can plug them in there. Everybody knows what this is for. And then they do give you just the traditional two stairs on this unit. And that is gonna do it for the outside of this 22BH. So let's go take a gander inside and see what this non-slide unit has to offer. Alrighty, welcome to the inside of the 22BH. As you see, it's nice, convenient, and compact. No sliding room. So this is all the access you get in the camper. Walk space, and you do get a walk space over here at the bed. And this is going to be your bedroom. You do have two little counters on the side there for you. If you have a CPAP machine or anything you need to plug in, you do have plugs on either side of this unit. And then what's nice, they do give you closet space up top. So you do get a nice big storage area on top of the unit for clothing. Like I said, the access panel from the inside, and you can do the storage. So if you lift this bed up, so there you get to see your storage from the outside. As you can see, I do have them open, so you can see the light, but at least it gives you full storage underneath the bed. And then, sorry about that. And then also what they just created is they have a Bluetooth speaker. So you have a Bluetooth speaker over here. You have two USB outlets for charging. Little thing that's a little extra, you know, because it is like a budget crunching camper. There are sticking tin units, but they give you a little bit extra, and then that Bluetooth stereo, which is pretty cool. Working our way over to the kitchen. So kitchen, you're gonna get your basics. So you're gonna get your two burner stove. You do get your fan yet too, which is nice. Turn your fan on. You do get your Furion microwave. So at least that's big enough to warm meals up, whatever you need to do. It's still big enough for you to do that. You get a cabinet space up top here. Sink isn't the biggest, but they're still trying to give you some counter space as well. So kind of offset the sink space, but still pretty tiny. You can do a couple dishes at a time. Everything that's new this year, you are getting a 12-volt refrigerator. So here's your 12-volt refrigerator. And I'm only plugged into the front. As you guys seen, I'm plugged into a little power source that we tow around here to hook these lights up. And this is fully on and going because it's a full 12-volt refrigerator. But you get a good amount of space in there for a 12-volt, especially in the freezer. And then this is going to be your little lock. So when you're traveling, that doors are not going to fly apart. And you do get two drawers underneath the two-burner stove. And you still get storage underneath the sink. And then heading over to our kitchen table. So this is going to be a booth dinette. So you get both sides on either end. You get a table. That table is going to go down into a bed for you. So a little bit of extra sleeping space. And then they give you storage above. So once again, you still get a good storage space above for some, put some clothing. This is for food, dishes, pantry, whatever you really need. At least they at least give a little bit to you. No TVs in here. Like I said, the price point. This isn't going to include any TVs or anything that's really extra. That really boosts up the MSRP of the unit. It's going to keep it down, but you do get a TV backer location. And then you do get your hookups above. So you get your both cable, satellite if you want it, and you get two plugs up there as well. And your Suburban heater. You have that there with two USB chargers. Working to the bunks. So these are going to be both your bunks. They're a little bit of the double wide, a little bit shorter than the other double wide, but yet you still get two big bunks on this unit. Still big enough for a kid, that's for sure. And then below, that one is gonna, you're able to get a window. You can open that up if you want to. And then above, they don't get a window, but you do get a skylight. So you still get a little bit of light in there, which is really nice. And then since the shower's not, the bathroom's not big enough for the shower, it's going to have its own little sink out here. So you do get a mirror. Hello. And then you do get your sink and outlets. And then you do get storage underneath that. A little bit of storage, you know, with being a non-slide unit, really runs out of room to put some spaces and put some things. So your storage unit, your storage runs out pretty quick here. Underneath the bed, there's your storage, like I said, underneath the bed, leading to that outside door. So this is a nice big storage area for you. So you can put totes, boxes, whatever you really need underneath. And that's going to just expand your storage a little bit more on this little coach. Heading to the bathroom. So you still get a big shower space in here. Here's your toilet. And they give you a curtain up there for the bathroom. And then on the other side, you do get counter space, some plugs. And then you do get, let's see the storage over here. So you do get storage space above there, and then obviously underneath they have to run all their plumbing. So shower update, little small. At least you have a curtain, so if my shoulders touch, I can still kind of take the curtain out and I'll get a little bit more arm space in here. Above, you don't really get a big moonlight. You do get a little fan. But if you're just doing quick showers and just need a rinse off, this will still work. So it's medium big guy approved. Hey guys, so that's gonna do it on this 22BH. Nothing big, nothing small, but if you're looking for a good sized bunkhouse to just get started on your camping Avenger, this is definitely one you wanna check out. Make sure you guys hit that like button, subscribe. If you guys have any comments, feedback, if you have an Avenger, let us know how it's going. If you guys are looking at other bunkhouses, let us know what other bunkhouses you would like to see. Until next time, have a good one.